Hi, I'm Norman Weilberger, and today we're going to have a look at projective geometry and one of the most important innovations in modern mathematical history, that of the introduction of homogeneous coordinates to pin down just what the projective plane really is. So let's start by reminding you about the regular Cartesian plane, where we have coordinates x and y. So that point there, for example, is the point 2, 1. And this line here has an equation like 2x plus y plus 1 equals 0. Now, in projective geometry, we want to augment this plane by adding points at the horizon. Now we can see that diagrammatically in this picture here. So here's the Cartesian plane that we had above. But we want to add points at infinity which correspond to points on the horizon. And how we do that is, we take parallel lines, so a family of parallel lines, say those ones there, and we agree that all of those parallel lines meet at a new point at infinity. That will ensure that any two lines, even if they're parallel, meet at a new point. A different family of parallel lines, say these ones here, will meet in another point at infinity. So we get a point at infinity for every family of parallel lines. And this collection of points, the new points that we're adding at infinity, we declare that to be a new line, the so-called line at infinity. Now this was the picture that mathematicians had of the projective plane for a few hundred years, from the 1600s up to the early 1800s. And once you work with this for a while, you get used to it. But it's also clear that there's something a little bit ambiguous about it, because it's not so clear what the role of these points really is. In the early 1800s, a completely new way of thinking about the projective plane was introduced, which completely changed the direction of the subject and introduced all kinds of new ideas and techniques. It was really one of the most important ideas in all of the history of mathematics, the idea of homogeneous coordinates. So what is this brand new, lovely idea? The idea is that the projective plane can really only be understood in the context of three-dimensional space. So in order to understand the two-dimensional projective plane, we really need to look at lines in three-dimensional space. This idea comes about from the work of Möbius and Plücker. So I have to remind you a little bit about three-dimensional geometry. So here is our representation of the three-dimensional space with an x-coordinate line, y-coordinate line, and a z-coordinate line. A point is specified by three coordinates, an x-coordinate, a y-coordinate, and a z-coordinate. So for example, the point 2, 5, 6, which is represented here, is obtained by going two steps in the x direction, taking five steps in the y direction, and six steps in the z direction. And we can combine those steps by drawing a box extending 2 units in this direction, 5 units in this direction, and 6 units up. And that corner of the box is the representation of the point 2, 5, 6. So that's three-dimensional space with coordinates x, y, and z. And we're going to use that as the framework. Inside there, we're going to find the projective plane by looking at lines through the origin. So the lovely new idea is that to understand the projective plane, we should look at three-dimensional space and lines in it going through the origin. Here's a picture of three-dimensional space with our coordinates x, y, and z. And here we see a bunch of lines through the origin. There's a reference plane. This plane z equals 1 plays an important role. It's parallel to the plane z equals 0, which is the xy plane, but moved up 1 in the z direction. And the reason it's important is because any line through the origin, which is not horizontal, is going to intersect that reference plane in a unique point. So for example, this line here, which goes through the point x, y, z, goes through any other point which is obtained by scaling those three numbers. And if we scale so that the last coordinate is 1, it means dividing by z, we get x over z, y over z, 1. So that means that lines to the origin which are not horizontal are exactly in one-to-one correspondence with points on this reference Cartesian plane. And the other lines which are not included are the horizontal lines. They're the ones where z equals 0. And they correspond exactly to directions in the Cartesian plane. In other words, for every family of parallel lines up here, there's a corresponding unique line which is horizontal through the origin. So the lines through the origin which are horizontal correspond in this picture to points at infinity in the Cartesian plane. So it's a very powerful idea, and it allows us to also work algebraically. Because a line through the origin, say the one through the point x, y, z, can be represented by the proportion x to y to z. Proportion means that we're allowed to scale without changing the line. And to that line, we associate, by this process, the Cartesian point x over z, y over z, provided z is not equal to 0. So, for example, the Cartesian point 2, 1 is associated to the homogeneous coordinate or line 2 to 1 to 1. That represents the line through the origin and the point 2, 1, 1, which is also the same as the line through the origin and the point 6, 3, 3. Note, for example, that this convention is very useful to get rid of fractions. So if we have an ordinary point, 3 over 4 minus 7 over 4, that's associated to this triple, 3 to minus 7 to 4. And that's allowed us to get rid of the fractions, only integers appearing there. So horizontal lines, again, are associated to points at infinity, and there's one for every family of parallel lines in the Cartesian plane. So in this picture, points in the projective plane correspond to lines through the origin. In our next video, we're going to show that lines in the projective plane correspond to planes through the origin. And we're going to get a new perspective on what a line and the equation of a line really means. I hope you'll join me for that. I'm Norman Wahlberger. Thanks for listening.